We hear a lot about life at the North Pole. You know, that Santa guy gets some pretty great PR. But what about on the other side of the globe? What do you think of when you hear Antarctica? Ice? Snow? Icebergs? Well, you're not wrong. But it turns out there's a lot more than just ice and freezing temperatures. The world of the Antarctic tundra is one of the most extreme and challenging places on Earth. Picture a vast icy desert at the bottom of the globe, where temperatures can drop way below freezing and the sun sometimes disappears for months. And yet, some of our most precious life on the planet calls this place home. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Think about the Antarctic tundra biome like a giant snow globe. When you shake a snow globe, you see the snowflakes floating around and everything inside the snow globe is sort of connected. They belong together in this scene. A frozen winter wonderland. A biome is a group of things that all go together and support each other. Things like temperature, rainfall, plants, animals, and more. Some other biomes include deserts, grasslands, and rainforests. In grasslands, a lot of animals eat the grasses, and those grasses need to be supported by nutrient-rich soil full of worms and other tiny decomposers. The animals, grasses, and soil all survive and thrive in similar conditions. The same goes for the Antarctic tundra biome. The plants and animals that live here can only survive in this chilly wilderness. If you're interested in learning about each of the different biomes around the world, be sure to subscribe to Socratica Kids to follow along for more smart, fun biomes videos. The Antarctic tundra biome is the coldest and most extreme biome on Earth. Located at the South Pole, it's a frozen desert where temperatures can be colder than your freezer at home. There are no tall trees here, just little plants like lichen that cling to the frozen rocks. Even though it's full of ice and snow, the Antarctic tundra does have animal life, from playful penguins to giant whales swimming in the icy waters nearby. Now, just from the name Antarctic tundra, you probably figured out that this biome has something to do with Antarctica. Antarctica is the southernmost continent on Earth, covered almost entirely by ice. This ice forms a massive ice sheet, which is incredibly thick and blankets the land. Glaciers, which are slow-moving rivers of ice, flow from the high mountains toward the sea. When pieces of these glaciers break off, they become icebergs that float in the ocean. Antarctica's landscape also includes towering mountain ranges, vast ice plains, and deep valleys hidden beneath the ice. This forbidding landscape may feel alien, almost like a different planet, but for a certain rugged set of animals, it's home. In this video, we'll give you a sneak peek at these specially adapted animals, but we're planning to take a deeper dive in our next video series, all about the animals who live in the 11 different biomes. We need your help to make this series a reality. Socratica Kids is an educational nonprofit, and our videos are possible because of people like you. Donate today and help us make more smart, fun videos. Antarctica is the coldest place on Earth, with temperatures that drop much lower than your freezer at home. I mean, picture living inside your freezer and then making it even colder. Yikes! In winter, it can get as cold as negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 56 degrees Celsius, while in summer, depending on the specific location, it can warm up to about 59 degrees Fahrenheit or 15 degrees Celsius. But the Antarctic tundra is very large, so the temperatures will vary a lot depending on where you are and what time of year it is. Even though Antarctica is covered in ice and snow, it is technically a desert because it gets very little precipitation. Yep, just like the hot deserts we think of with lots of sand. There are hot deserts and cold deserts, and what they have in common is next to no rainfall, or snowfall in the case of the cold deserts. In fact, some parts of Antarctica get less than 2 inches of snow per year, which is less than many of the world's deserts get in rain. The cold temperatures make it hard for moisture to evaporate and form clouds, so it doesn't snow very often. That means when you picture Antarctica as that snow globe, there are just a few snowflakes. It's not just the climate that's extreme. Even the sun gets in on the action. In the summer, the sun never sets, and it's daylight all the time, while in winter, the sun disappears for months, leaving the continent in constant darkness. The only other place in the world that experiences this is the Arctic biome, or the North Pole. This is because Earth is tilted, so as the Earth rotates around the Sun, the poles will experience either the most or the least sunlight at any given time. You can hear the story of the other end of the globe in our video about the Arctic tundra, linked below. When we say flora, you might think of flowers, but there aren't any flowers in the freezing Antarctic tundra. You won't find any tall plants, no trees, no shrubs, no roses, no sunflowers. But there are some amazing tiny plants that manage to survive in this icy cold. Mosses, lichens, and algae are the true champions of this frozen land. Everything else depends on them. Mosses are like little green carpets that grow close to the ground, soaking up any bit of moisture they can find. Lichens are super tough, living on rocks and even on the ice itself. Algae are tiny plant-like organisms that can live in the snow and ice, turning some parts of the ice bright green or red. These plants have special tricks to survive, like going dormant during the harshest times and waking up when conditions are just right. They show us that even in the most extreme environments, life can find a way to thrive. What about the fauna, the animal life? In the Antarctic tundra, animals have developed some amazing adaptations to survive in the extreme cold. Adaptations are special traits or behaviors that help a plant or animal survive in its environment. We saw how plant life is adapted to the Antarctic tundra biome by being very small. The animals went in a different direction. Penguins, like the emperor penguin, have thick layers of blubber and dense feathers to keep warm. They huddle together in large groups to share body heat during the coldest times. Many birds, like the Antarctic petrel, need to stay lighter for flight, so they can skip the heavy blubber, but instead have special feathers that trap air for extra insulation. The Antarctic tundra is also home to some semi-aquatic mammals, such as the Weddell seal, which have a thick layer of blubber and can slow their heart rate to stay warm while swimming in icy waters. Beneath the icy waters of Antarctica, a bustling world of marine life thrives too. It's like living in a constant ice bath. Wow. Phytoplankton, which are like microscopic floating plants doing photosynthesis, and tiny shrimp-like creatures called krill are the foundation of the Antarctic food web, serving as a crucial food source for many larger animals. Fish in these cold waters have some special proteins in their blood that work sort of like antifreeze. This helps the fish swim in icy cold temperatures. Giant whales, like the blue whale, migrate to these waters to feast on the abundant krill. There are also seals that dive deep to hunt for fish and squid. This underwater world is a remarkably active part of the Antarctic tundra biome, supporting a whole bunch of different animals that are perfectly suited to live in their cold aquatic home. The Antarctic tundra is truly one of a kind, with no other place on Earth quite like it. Because of this, scientists from all over come to this remote part of the world to learn about the isolated plant and animal species that are so different from other life on planet Earth. it's really hard to get here. They have to travel across some seriously dangerous waters in a boat that can handle giant waves. These scientists live and work in research stations, braving the cold to uncover the secrets of this frozen land. Climate researchers can study the ice to learn about what the conditions were like on Earth thousands of years ago. Biologists can observe the hardy plants and animals and discover what they do to survive in such extreme conditions. There are even astronomers who use the clear, dark skies to study stars and galaxies. Antarctica is a pretty cool place, and we don't just mean the temperature. From its icy landscapes and unusual plants to the cleverly adapted animals and bustling marine life, this frozen world is full of wonders. Remember, even in the coldest, most extreme places on Earth, life finds a way to survive. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.